when we talk about the compatibility in astrology, it really is determined by the astrologer. Each astrologer has a different idea of what is compatible and what isn't compatible. Mostly what is compatible in astrology is what movement is happening within the universe at the time. So if we work, say, with a Capricorn and Scorpio, their signs are usually not as compatible as one would hope, but there is a compatibility because one is more watery and the other one is more earth. So there can be a very good balance. Also with Scorpios can be very intense, and they could be very passionate, and they could bring this part of the Capricorn out if the Capricorn allows it. So I would see it as a match. Some astrologers would disagree, but if a Capricorn is lacking in showing their passion, the best sign to bring that out would be a Scorpio. So therefore, it does work. But you also have to remember, within the compatibility, we're talking about a movement that continues on and on and on and on. And so the compatibility is already there. We as human beings are already compatible. But there can be specific days in astrology when we're not, depending on where the moon is and the constellations and the signs and things like that. One day we could be on, one day we could be off. And this is not something that people should measure within their compatibility. Just because one day everything's great, the Scorpio is really bringing out the Capricorn's passion and, you know, they're having a really good time in the sack. And then the next day the Scorpio turns away from the Capricorn. The Capricorn becomes a little bit moody about that and storms off. It doesn't mean that the compatibility is lost. It just means that as the universe is in constant motion, so are we. So the general compatibility would be for the Scorpio to bring out the passion of the Capricorn. And that's where the compatibility would lie. But the compatibility also lies in the fact that we're human beings, and human beings are pretty much compatible within their romance and within their natures. But it all really depends on the conditioning of each person. If we decide, no, I can't be with a person that is just too reliable and too set and too organized in their ways, and that turns out to be a choice. It's not really non-compatibility. And so this is what's very important to look at, is compatibility has to be brought down to choice, that it's your choice. Know that when you work with the different signs, just look at the signs and say, hey, you know, Scorpio seems really good for me. You know, the intensity, the sexual prowess, the Scorpio and I could get along really well. But everything doesn't have to be determined about a finality to a relationship. But if you could see the characteristics and traits that the person can bring to you that you can share and enjoy together, that is what makes us compatible.